so much about kings and queens and castles and palaces. And today we're going to talk more about palaces. But instead of me just going on and on and on and on and talking to you, we're going to do some virtual tours of palaces around the world. So we're going to hop into different videos of palaces in different places. You're going to see one in China, one in Versailles in France, and one in Hawaii in the United States. So get ready. Pretend we're hopping on an airplane. We have our plane tickets, and we're going over to Versailles, which is in Versailles, France. Are you ready for the tour? All right, I'm going to close my mouth and let you all go into this tour.
Hey guys, what's up? I'm Jean-Philippe, and today I will show you my queue. Follow me. Everything gotta have his crown, right? So welcome to the palace, aka the Palace of Versailles. As the French could say, the Château de Versailles. By the way, shout out to the last tenant. Let's start with the Royal Opera House. I like to think that this place is my personal home cinema. Opera and chill, you know. Now follow me to the King's Bed. To wake up here every morning, so wow. Let's keep moving, shall we? Whoa! So this is the famous hall of mirrors. 357 mirrors, 17 windows, you know, just looking. This is my favorite one. She's pretty special. A sculpture recovered from the Roman times. She spent a lot of time in the Louvre, but now she's back in my crib. Time is up. That's it for me, guys. Hope you enjoy my crib. Now it's your turn to put on the crown. The palace is yours.
Isn't that wild? Someone used to actually live there. Let's see what another palace has in store. Here we go.
Hey guys, what's up?
Okay, next up, we have the Forbidden City in Beijing, China. Are you ready for our virtual tour? Okay, here we go.
For nearly 500 years, the Forbidden City was the home of China's emperors. And off limits to anyone outside of the imperial court. Built in the 15th century at the heart of the ancient walled city of Beijing, the massive palace complex was the political heart of China during the Ming and Qing dynasties. Spanning an enormous 178 acres and boasting more than 9,000 rooms, It's the largest and best preserved collection of ancient buildings in China. The Supreme Harmony Gate, overlooks a massive courtyard where audiences of up to 100,000 people gather for imperial ceremonies. Beyond the gate, in the heart of the Forbidden City, lies the most important building, the Hall of Supreme Harmony. During the Qing Dynasty, emperors held birthdays, weddings, and coronations here, making it not only the largest building, but also the most sacred. Made from glazed tiles and marble, the impressive Nine Dragon Screen was commissioned by the Emperor Tianlong in the 18th century.
The yellow dragon at its center symbolizes the emperor as the imperial power on the dragon throne.
Situated midway between heaven and earth.
We've been to France. We've been to China. Let's see where we're about to go next. Let's see. Ooh, this is the Aulani Palace in Honolulu, Hawaii, in the United States. Let's see what we find here.
Aulani Palace, the only state residence of royalty on American soil. Hawaii's last monarchs lived and ruled here more than 100 years ago. This, the last Hawaiian royal palace, is being restored to its former grandeur. Aulani Palace reminds us that Hawaiians once had their own kingdom. Here, our history comes alive, and we can experience the spirit of old Hawaii. From this palace, King Kalakaua ruled the kingdom with regal elegance. With his queen, Kapi'olani, he continued an earlier tradition. Their monarchy was fashioned after that of British kings and queens.
So we have so much to learn. I have to stop the video now because we are running out of time, but if you ever want to look up about other palaces in the world, you can always find videos of them yourself. Now, I know it's pretty cool to be looking at all of these things, but just remember, there are so many palaces all around the world. And like we said before, there are still kings and queens alive today. I hope you thought the palaces were pretty cool. Remember to click on the exit ticket below, and you're going to talk about this video with Mr. Malcolm. See you later, kindergarten.